Okay, so first of all, yesterday I gave you the Melegio folder with example, and so please download these new SIM files and delete the previous one I gave you in the simulation calibration folder.
The one of yesterday?
Yeah.
So we have two and white then.
Yeah. So you have two folders, simulation calibration and simulation validation. Okay. In this case, you have the 7 sim file plus the graph.sim. So select this simulation and replace it with the new one. And put the Lucas cal.sim in the folder simulation calibration. Okay. There are also two JARS files and put this in the lib folder.
Is there a way on OSF to download all the files at the same time?
Okay, so download all the files, then put the JAR files in the library folder in lib. Okay, and then replace the all the SIM file in the simulation validation folder. I replace it with the new one. And put the Luca simulation in simulation calibration. Water budget .jar put in lib folder, in the lib folder.
Graph.sim, what is done?
Graph.sim in simulation validation.
Yes,
plus the graph.sim.
In simulation validation?
No, in a simulation validation.
Aradiga
is.
At the end we will have a project working with a have different versions of the simulator.
Okay.
We need to have a final so when
the zip file.
Yeah, final zip file with the project.
Okay, yeah. At the end this evening I can
even next week. I mean
yesterday I gave you the Meledrio case study with seven different folders. One folder for each sub-basin, and inside each folder there is the centroid of this basin, the dam of this basin, the scaling factor, and the potential evapotranspiration, leaf area index, precipitation, radiation, and air temperature in the centroid, this basin, obviously. Okay? So, probably you don't have the file in the ASCII format. You probably have only the diff. Okay. And then we have seven different sim files, one for each sub-basin. The sim file is the sim that Ricardo showed you before about the embedded reservoir model.
Those are in the simulation for the
simulation validation. There are three different kind of sim file. Is for the upper basin, the edge of the graph. So here the runoff is generated only by the precipitation, and then these are the same, and this case in our basin is represented by the basin number 1, 5, 7 and 6. Ricardo, is in Net3 the graph of...
No.
Oh, okay, no, this.
What are you looking for?
This, this is me. Okay. So, the big, the sub-basin 1, 5, 6, and 7. Are essentially edge of our graph, and then we have other basin where the runoff is generated by the precipitation plus the runoff of the other basin. Okay,
this is counted inside the simulation of the subject and not in the graph.
It's in the graph. It's in sim file.
And the numbers are okay.
Okay. So the structure of the sim file is equal, more or less. For example, another point, if you can find the area of the sub-basin and at the end of simulation the length, the channel.
This is square kilometers.
And at the end, we have the outfluxes. We have only outfluxes, and the same for the sim file number 5. We don't have any input except the precipitation that is some. Then we have the precipitation reader, and the same for the sim file 6 and 7. Okay, in the sim file number 2, we have the runoff that is generated by the precipitation, and on the runoff of the basin number 1 to number 5. So, in this case, at the end, we will have some influxes, okay, given by the basin number 1 and number 5, and again, some outfluxes, okay. And again, for example, in the basin number 3, I will add in input the basin number 2 and number 6. So at the end, I will add in input the fluxes of the basin number 2, number 6, and so on. Is different for the basin number 4, that is the output of our system. In this case, we will have at the end of the sim file only the influxes and nothing in output. There are also different connection, just to, for example, I have here for node for the input. And here I have also a full writer in order to write the hydrograph and the storage of the basin. Okay. In the same files, I have some parameter. So how can I run all the sim file as a graph with the graph sim file? In this case, I will have a path to the connection basin. Okay, the basin are connected in this way. Basin number 5 goes to the basin number 2, the 1, the number 2, number 2, the number 3, the 6, the number 3, and so on. And the output is 4 that goes in 0, always. The output is always the number 0.
Do you have to put them in a specific order? Or
no, 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 no. And there is the path to the sim file. The reader of parameters file. This is the one that Ricardo showed you before.
What is that?
I is in data. As a topo medio. Okay, then
this is number.
All the
flat. Then? Probably I missed something, but in the trip, for instance, in 3-point sim flat, in the sim file number 3,
okay, yeah.
The influxes and the outfluxes are the variable, are the fluxes coming from the
the basin number 2 and the basin number 6.
Yeah, from the upstream.
Yeah.
Maybe, okay. Number 2 and number 6. Okay. Yeah. What is in node 1, in bar 1, in node 2, in bar 2?
Are the input.
But so, in this sim file, you should take care that your input, your upstream input are 2 and not 1.
Yes.
Ah, okay. You should modify any.
If you have just 1 input. Something like this.
Remove the sixth line.
Yes.
And the other above. Okay.
And in this case, the node is 2. Okay.
Ah, because in order are progressive in memory. Ah,
yeah.
You should modify. If you add, for instance, if you add a new sub basin on that, imagine on that point.
Exactly.
Just insert a new line for any variable.
Yes.
For each variables.
In this case, you. You have to modify also the component. In this case,
okay.
You have for a component, two for the masking gun, and two for
okay. There is a declaration of all fluxes coming upstream. So the variables, what is discharge, and the other one is
storage.
Sorry?
The storage.
Ah. The volume, okay.
Yeah. And, okay.
So the procedure is, first we manually, we just have to fill the file with the connections. That one is created by its mother.
The default parameter is the flag. Otherwise, with overwrite, you will use the parameter in the params.csv file and overwrite in the simulation.
Okay.
Okay.
So, just to understand if I. Okay, if you put out different parameters file, you can just declare over there.
Yes, so
for example, if I want the first three attachments, use the params.csv, yeah, and the remainder of them use the another parameter file like params2.csv.
Okay, yes.
How you manage this?
In the version that Riccardo showed you in the slide, you can read for each sub-basin a single param file. Okay. Otherwise, this is the old version. If you want, for example, in the basin number one, another set of parameter, essentially you can change all the parameter in your file.
Okay.
And let the letter overwrite.
Okay, just let the overwrite.
Okay.
Just leave one between
in that way,
okay.
I guess. I'm not sure. I don't remember. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And for example, this case. Okay, for example, okay, in this case for Melero we have a gauge here. So in this case we can calibrate first the basin number 6, okay, change all the parameter in the simulation, and then run the graph for the full basin. But in this case we can go in the sim file number 6, calibrate, false, because we already have the optimal set of parameters. Okay, more or less it is tool. Okay, so if I run the graph dot sim, if I run the graph.sim, okay, it will read for the external basins, and then gives you all the result, all the parameter, that's it. Okay, at the end, you will add in the output folder the hydrograph and the storage. Because in the simulation number 4, he had a writer at the end. Yeah.
So if by chance you had put there to calibrate one subcatchment, this does it automatically, or you have to just focus on that catchment and then tell you how
you
manage
if you want to calibrate one subcatchment, only one?
Yeah.
Okay, no, you have to focus on that
subcatchment.
Okay,
no. So you could just modify the seam, no, just modify
the topo.
So how you launch the calibration from just one subcatchment?
First of all, I mean the hydrogram. So in this case, for example, I want to calibrate the number 6. Okay, so I have to add another topo file. But the connection is 6, 0, okay. Okay. Remove the output fluxes. Is way and add writer.
Okay. Yeah, I think I understood. So it's the same concept.
So at the end, I will have the hydrograph only for the basin of the six, and then I have to calibrate with the other same file we have called.
Okay.
The hydrograph of the basin number six with.
But Luca calibrate the parameters against what?
Against the observed measurement.
So
you have to compare the hydrograph simulator with the one observed,
okay.
And the Luca change the all the parameters.
You still have observation, of course.
Yeah.
So Luca
I
have a reader of observations somewhere, right?
Can you? Yeah.
Hey,
Luca is
calibration. Case in Luca you have to specify the input and the start date and the end date.
Always a question. In the map, we have to change all the hashing difference in the funds because we only have
the I don't know, probably this works, probably not. I always use
Noce. So we have to we just have to translate over.
Yes. Data. So then here you have the part of the topo, the part of the same file, where the calibrated parameters are saved. In the folder ESC Luca. The original parameter file and the list of the parameter with the range and the calibration strategy. And at the end, the function, the same file. In this case, the one printed by the graph, let's see, against the observer. And this is the number of execution. For example, if I want to calibrate only some parameter, I can comment the other. In this case, for example, the mix of masking up will be the one in the parent file. Okay.
Can you explain the syntax also for each parameter? Lower is the lower value, upper is the upper value, and what is the increment step?
What increment?
I imagine that there is a kind of loop that moves all the parameters step by step and try to find the best combination.
Yes, so lower and upper are the
extremes.
Yeah, extreme. Mean is the calibration strategy, but I don't know how the shuffle complex evolution does it work, so I trust the process.
Yeah. Just a quick stupid question. The observed data usually are discharged in the unit of time.
Yes.
Portare
yeah,
varie.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so yes.
Yes, percent per hour is a cubic meter per hour,
second.
Per second. Okay.
Okay. So the idea is take your time series. In this case, our time series starts in 2010, and at the end of 2013. So the idea is to calculate for the first period and then validate for the second one, but if you want you can calibrate also on the worst period, depends on you. So
the validation run.
How to run
the validation. I mean, let's assume we have calibrated our models.
Okay, so you have to run with Docker. The first case, the craft.sim, and for the calibration, Luca, the school start.
Thank you for, sorry for the
No, no, you're welcome.
Do you understand?
Can you initialize the storage of the rest of the...
I don't know.
Non ho capito la domanda.
What's the status of the reservoir at time zero? Is it initialized somewhere?
I don't remember actually. But usually we start with I think we can fix the initial state. Usually we start with zero and make it trans for a while
before calibrating.
Yeah. We have a spin up.
Yeah. If I run graph.sim,
yes,
this is the name essentially.
Yes, sorry.
Graph.sim.
Yeah.
Here you simulate the run.
Yes.
One. You will get fixed parameters.
Yes. And then you can calibrate the parameter. Mm-hmm. And then you can run again the graph.sim. Using the optimal, yes, and essentially changing it in the...
What time does it take?
Our graph.sim is quite fast, I guess. I tried for 1 year, and it takes more or less 1 minute.
1 minute?
Yes.
Notebook file is available for us or did you give us or not?
No, but it's not yet. Just a couple of cells with the Docker command. For example, if I run the graph.sim,
graph.sim that is running everything.
Yes.
Okay.
Series with the ID value 4 with this observer.
The two CSV contains the time series simulated and the observed one.
Yes.
Only one time series.
No, you can have different time series. For example, in the hydrograph, I have just one time series. Okay. And in the observer, we have three time series.
But the calibration is based only on one.
Yes.
So you set the first, the second. So, okay, it's one variable. Okay.
There I have two values, the value ID, and Luca.
Okay, okay, okay. One column, one column.
This is the station with this value 9398. Is the station that measures these charts at the end of the watersheds outlet? Because
in this case, yes.
The last sub-basin.
In this case, this is the station.
So if
in Malet at the end of the Meleggio. So now you can start. If you want, you can try to run the graph.sim using the TIFF file. Really, I don't know if it works, probably, or probably not. Otherwise, you can change with the QGIS the format, compare the format to ASCII. Okay.
Perché è così tanto?
Come hanno fatto?